Starts when the whistle blows. It's a sad short life. We're down and home. 12 tons of coal on a big iron sled. I work all day for a cold hard bed. Now heaven knows where heaven lies. There ain't no gold in a Tennessee mine.
Have some weapons? Something we can take him out with?
Well, don't look at me.
I think I know a place where there's a big stockpile. It's that way.
Well, we're gonna be walking a while. May as well get to know each other. You guys got any stories? I got a question. Shoot, what's with your aim?
Well, you see, the last bounty I took on, right before you, it didn't go so hot.
Ended up with both my wrists broken and no body to turn in. Was left without a penny to my name and couldn't pay a doctor to fix my wrists. So when the bones healed, they didn't heal so straight. My bones are weak and the recoil from the gun really takes a toll. Hurts a whole heck of a lot to shoot a pistol, and can't aim that straight because of it. But I needed food, and so I was forced to take your bounty. Figured if I snuck up on you and shot the gun right to your head that it wouldn't be an issue. But I could never have anticipated a passive sheriff would try to stop me from killing. And that raises my next question. Why is it that you went pacifist?
It happened a long time ago. When I was a young boy, my father used to be the sheriff of the town, and I was his little deputy. One day, some rabble-rousers came to town and started trouble.
Hey, you.
My daddy went to put a stop to it, and they beat him until he was dead. Only thing was, he threw the first punch and never tried to talk it out. His love of violence got him killed, and I just can't understand why. Violence doesn't seem to solve anything, as we've seen in the last few days, so I don't want any part in creating it.
Son, my ass! They kicked my ass!
Now I got a question. How'd you end up a robin man in the first place?
My story goes a little something like this. A few months ago, I heard a rumor that some rich folk were doing for a ride through town. So I robbed them blind and took off running. I had to get home because, well, I mean, because my wife was dying. A few months ago, she got diagnosed with tuberculosis, and lately she ain't been doing so hot. We were never very well off, and I was forced to get the money quick. So I did the only thing I could think of by robbing that stagecoach. Got my wife the medicine to erase the pain, but he was never gonna fix her. The only thing I didn't take into account is that I didn't hide my face. They all saw me.
And so I fled, and I ran. I ran real far too, and then y'all found me.
She's dead now, isn't she? And you weren't there for her because of us.
I try not to dwell on it too much.
I'm sorry. Look, if we survive Boris, I'll drop the bounty. Does that sound okay to you, Sheriff?
Yes.
All right, let's dig ourselves up a body. Only one gun. I thought you said this was a stockpile.
It was a stockpile.
You realize there's three of us, right?
One gun will be enough.
Who is this anyway? It's your coat.
Yeah, I took it off and gave it to some guy, and then he buried him.
Not much of a pacifist, are you?
Hey, it was a necessary evil.
Here, you got the holster. Why don't you take it? Don't have to aim for it anyway.
Well, what say we set up camp somewhere, figure out what to do next.
Very well. I'm for it.
Boris, I have a confession. I hired Boris to kill you.
You what?
I hired him to kill you.
Why are you telling us this now?
You see, I was having a lot of fun tagging along with you boys.
You was having fun? We almost died!
You could have called him off this whole time?
Yeah.
You know what? He'll probably be here in 10 minutes anyway. Let's just wait it out. We can have you call him off. How does that sound?
I'll call him off.
Holy crap!
Now put your hands up there, boys!
Boris, it's over.
What do you mean it's over?
It's over, Boris.
It ain't over till I say it's... Are you colluding with the enemy, Nasher?
Boris, put the gun down.
Hey! Shut up. You're the one conspiring with these low lives and criminals. Now I'm gonna give y'all boys two options. I can bring you in warm, or I can bring you in cold.
How about I give you an option, Mr. Boris? Get him, boys.
Oh, okay.
How big are your pockets?
Get him, boys!
I don't want to get him, he's got a katana!
Pull out your gun!
Oh, right!
Great heavens to Betsy, that's a big-ass gun!
Everybody, skedaddle!
Ah! so much on you. Still more I need your love. I need your love. God, speed your love to me.
Time out over.
Only rivers flow to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Wait for me, I'll be coming home. Wait for me. Oh, my love.
Hey there. Say, you got any firepower?
I got this here dynamite. It's not really meant for killing people. It's kind of meant for mining. You guys want it?
We're gonna need to borrow that.
Out of there, fellas.
You know, boys, I've been on a lot of bounties in my life. But y'all three are by far the most irritating. Like, I can't even describe it. I have chased y'all forests, and fields, and rivers, and mountain ranges. And now, sitting here, looking at y'all three, I am going to very much enjoy killing each and every one of you. Are y'all even paying attention?
Giddy up.
What? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. My bad, what were you saying?
Gave y'all boys an option. Y'all chose cold.
It's not even lit. Really?
Could I get a redo?
Nope.
Oh, not me. I got a wife waiting for me back home.
Not for long.
What do you mean? You take it. I don't want it. What? You got nothing to live for. I gotta spread my pacifist word. What? Forget that.
Oh, Dios mio, that was a close one.
I don't want it. Oh, damn it. You take it.
Well, looks like we got ourselves a good old-fashioned Mexican.
David, you're in the shot.
I know.
Yeah. Okay.
Am I in the shot?
No.
Three, two, one.
Right.